Right. These are squashed ammonites from the Kimmage clay. Most people don't pay attention to these at all because they're squashed flat. Most people like to collect ammonites in the rain, like 3D, because they look really, really nice. So no one's ever paid much attention to these squashed ammonites. But what, when you do collect these squashed ammonites, interestingly, what I was finding were actually lots and lots of specimens with big chunks taken out. And when you look at these chunks in relation to the other sections that you find they're quite comparative, okay? And it must have been predation, you know, there's something, because when you collect these on the sea floor, there's no evidence of the broken shell debris around the ammonite. So it's not happened in the sort of sea floor, like a lobster's gone in there and cracked the shell up or whatever to get at the inside. Presumably it would go in from the open end anyhow, so there's no, you know, reason why it should break the shell there. But of course, when you study an ammonite, that break is right on the back of what we call the body chamber. So the soft tissue of the animal lives in what we call the body chamber, but it's anchored into that body chamber by it's sort of stuck on the back of the body chamber. But if you can break that attachment, naturally you can take the soft tissue right out. So it's so commonplace that I thought there's got to be predation, but of what? We initially thought, or I initially thought it might have been fish, but I don't think fish are that clever. Because if you get fish with big crushing teeth, it could actually deal with these ammonites quite, you know, okay. But it's something that must be more clever than that. We think it's actually cuttlefish that can actually just swim up to these things, grab on them with their tentacles, and they've got these parrot-like beaks that actually just break that shell and just take the soft tissue out. Now, we find them in the squashed ammonites, those marks, but also there's a 3D one there that shows the same sort of chunk taken out, okay? And it's through the whole of the Kimmage clay. It's not just through one particular area. It's actually endemic right through the whole of this Kimmage clay starter. So it's something that no one else has really picked on, but we even find them on the microconchs, the males as well. So we find evidence of damage. And so it's something that no one's really noted before, but it's something that's quite interesting, although these squashed ammonites to most people.